Welcome to the LightningChart JavaScript tutorial series. In this video, we will set up a complete testing environment for LSA.js. This video is targeted for everyone interested in LSA.js. Programming experience is not strictly necessary. First, let's download our project template. The link for this GitHub repository can be found in the video description. Download the template by pressing code, download zip. Next, unzip the download and rename it to something more suitable. I will now open the directory in Visual Studio Code, but you can use any file editor for this purpose. This is the simplest LightningChart project template. Code is in the form of a single HTML file. It can be opened by simply dragging it into a web browser. Here I show it with Google Chrome. Now let's create a simple chart from scratch. Here we create an XY chart and place it in the web page. Next, we create a line series. And finally, let's generate some random data and add it into the series. Refresh the page to see the changes. I will now demonstrate the default interactions of LightningChart. Panning is activated by holding down the right mouse button. Panning can also be applied on a singular axis only. Mouse wheel can be used to zoom in and out. Better zoom control can be achieved by holding down the left mouse button and selecting the zoom region. This too can be applied on a particular axis. Here you can see the data cursor in action. Data can be fitted into view by holding down the left mouse button and swiping left. I will now show how to get started with the TypeScript project template. TypeScript is the intended framework for developing LightningChart JS, so I strongly recommend that everyone give it a try. Before proceeding, make sure you have Node.js installed. The installation link can be found in the video description. Download and open the TypeScript project template like before. This link is in the description as well. Start the TypeScript project by opening a terminal and executing the following commands: npm install, and npm start. Afterwards, go into your web browser and type in the following address: localhost colon 8080. In this template, the application code can be found in source app.ts file. It is good to know that TS files stand for TypeScript, meaning that the programming language has now changed. With TypeScript enabled, we now have access to automatic code completion. Documentation, as well as dynamic error checks, which in most cases ensures that your code will work as intended. It is also worth noticing that we now have access to hot reload, which means that as soon as you save the file, the chart will automatically refresh. You're now ready to get started with your very own LightningChart JS projects, or to continue along with the next videos in the series, where we will explore some of the most common chart applications with LightningCharts.